we have seen in the last 30 to 40 years, the populations of elephants globally, both in Asia and Africa, declining by 50%. So we now only have 170,000 elephants, while 40 years ago we had over a million elephants. So we have seen a severe decline in the number of elephants. Japan is, with China now, is the only country that is authorized by CITES to buy elephant ivory internationally. If I may remind you, there was a global ban on international trade in ivory, which was put by CITES in 1989. But in 2000, Japan was able and authorized by CITES to buy ivory from Africa. So Japan and now China are the only two countries that that buy ivory. The problem is that the trade in ivory in Japan is not well regulated, and it provides room for illegal ivory to get into Japan. And as long as there is illegal trade in ivory, the elephants will continue to be poached in both Africa and Asia. So we say that as long as Japan continues to buy, it will continue to provide motivation for poachers to kill elephants in Africa. We would want Japan to stop trading in ivory. The most important thing that the Japanese community would do is to stop buying ivory for products like hankos. You could produce hankos from wood or from plastics, and if the community in Japan would choose to buy hankos that are made from other products and not hankos made of ivory, then they would directly be helping to stop the killing of elephants in Africa and Asia. IFO has a global elephant program that works to help conserve elephants both in Africa and Asia. We do this by working through management authorities. That's the government authorities that have got a mandate to conserve wildlife in their own countries, and also with the local communities that live with elephants or live in the same habitat as elephants. With the wildlife authorities, the government authorities, our job is to enhance their capacities through training and equipping them. But with the local communities is to educate them about elephants and their needs and how they can live harmoniously in their environment with the elephants. I would urge the audience of Green TV also to be sensitive to the environment, to take action to protect elephants, whether we are talking about brown bears in Japan or the forests in Japan or anywhere in Africa where they are able, when they travel out as tourists, to be able to share their love for nature and also take action to make sure that nature and the environment is protected for this generation and the future generations.